Front wheel drive cars give power to front wheels. Rear wheel drive cars give power to rear wheels. And all wheel drive cars give power to all the four wheels. And if you think that is the end of topic, you're so wrong. It's not the end of topic, it's where the topic starts. So just hang on, because by the end of the video, you'll know how these drive things work and should you buy a front wheel drive car, a rear wheel drive car, or an all wheel drive car. So hang on. Welcome to AutoRage Explained, where I tell you about automobile technology super simplified so that you can understand your vehicle better. Now, if you want to watch this video in Hindi, click on the link in the description bar below, because AutoRage India Hindi is a Hindi channel and AutoRage India, which you are watching right now, it's an English channel. Let's get straight into the topic. But before that, if you're confused on your next new car purchase, we have a solution for you at the end of the video. So to simplify it, we have divided this topic in three parts. In first part, you'll know about technological aspects of all these drive systems. In second part, you'll know about driving experience of all these drive systems. And in third part, we'll talk about should you buy a front wheel drive car, a rear wheel drive car, or an all wheel drive car. And if you think that it's a long theory class in which you are going to get bored, no, it's not. Just look at the remaining time below. I know it's a bit long, but it's going to be fun. So watch the whole video, because we have put in so much effort to make this video simple for you. If you really want to understand these three types of transmission systems, first, you need to understand a little bit of basics first. An engine is the powerhouse of a car. It can be mounted in front of the car or rear of the car or in middle of the car. And we are going to focus on front mounted engines because they are common. So front mounted engines can be mounted in two directions. By direction of engine, I mean the direction in which cylinders are aligned. And you know that your car's engine is a combination of cylinders. If you don't know that, well, it's a combination of cylinders which have those piston boxing up and down, and they rotate the crankshaft. So the direction where the crankshaft points is the direction engine is aligned. Now, if you want to know how an engine works, check out our video on engines. And trust me, after watching that video, you will understand engines like never before. So the direction in which engines are aligned. So first direction is in which engine is longitudinally mounted, where direction of engine is along the length of the car. Longitudinal length, L, easy to remember. And second direction is transverse, where direction of engine is along the width of the car. So longitudinal and transverse engine mounting, sorted. Let's get straight into the topic. Engine powers the drive shaft, and drive shaft rotates the wheel with the help of axle and differential, which divides the power. So in front wheel drive cars, engine is usually mounted transversely. Now, because engine is in transverse position and crankshaft rotates in the direction we want the wheels to rotate, and the wheels which are getting power are also in front. Hence, there are less mechanical components required to transfer power from engine to wheels. And less components means less weight, and less weight means better fuel economy. In rear wheel drive cars, large engines are usually mounted longitudinally because drive shaft has to go all the way back to the rear differential, which then divides the power to both the drive wheels. And if the engine is small, and by small I mean 4-cylinder less than 2.5 liters, it can be mounted transversely. Also for rear wheel drive cars, as transverse engine can free space for passenger compartment. So in that case, direction of power flow has to be changed 2 times, which also means that additional weight is there because of drive shaft. Haven't you seen a drive shaft? I bet you have. When a truck passes by, just observe a shaft which goes from front to all the way back, which is clearly visible. That is drive shaft. In all-wheel drive cars, engine can be mounted longitudinally as well as transversely, because in either case, they have to change the direction of transmission of power. This is longitudinal arrangement in four-wheel drive cars, and this is transverse arrangement in four-wheel drive cars. And how does this change of power happens? Magic. Well, there are a lot of gears enclosed in a magical box known as differential, with the help of which this is done. Time to understand difference in driving experience. In front wheel drive cars, front wheels have to do so much work. They have to steer the vehicle, they have to transmit the power. And when you stop, up to 70% of the weight is on front wheels. And above that, there is a byproduct of asking front wheels to do a lot of work, and that is torque steer. It's a sexy name though. Basically, torque steer is when you suddenly accelerate your front wheel drive car, and if you are not holding the steering, the car dangerously steers itself to one side. Well, how do you stop it? Hold that steering when you drive your front wheel drive car. Also, when you take a turn, front wheel cars understeer, and understeer is when car takes longer distance to turn than anticipated. Now, in rear wheel drive cars, the wheels get better traction when you accelerate your car in a straight line. Because when you accelerate a car, the car squats and maximum weight is on rear wheels. And fortunately, they are the wheels which are getting power. You want to know more about traction? Watch our video on traction control system. And that is how we promote our other videos because nobody watches them. But when you turn your rear wheel drive car in high speed, it oversteers. And oversteer is when your car turns more rapidly than anticipated. At the same time, if you are a richy-rich and you have a powerful rear wheel drive car, when you suddenly accelerate, your rear wheel drive car have more chances of losing control. Because it is similar to pushing trolley in supermarket or airport, where you push it from rear. If your front wheel miss out on right direction, you can totally lose your control. But at the same time, rear wheel drive cars are maximum fun because you can do this. And this. And they are better off-roaders than front wheel drive cars. Now comes the big daddy cool, all wheel drive system. Now it is true that all wheel drive vehicles get maximum traction because all the four wheels are getting power. But the downside is that engine has to provide power to all the wheels, hence more energy is needed. And there are more components which are required. And more weight plus more energy required equals to less fuel economy. At the same time, it is true that all-wheel drive cars have maximum grip, hence maximum control in all conditions. So they are the safest to drive on off-road and on track, but in city commute, they don't really make any difference. So which is faster, front-wheel drive car, rear-wheel drive car or all-wheel drive car? You see, there are positives and negatives of all these three drive systems. But it is clear that front-wheel drive cars lose out on track with rear-wheel drive cars and all-wheel drive cars. But at the same time, how often do you race on track? So the real answer to the question, which one is the fastest? Theoretically, it's all-wheel drive cars, but by a margin of just that little bit. And practically, it depends on a lot of other factors. Now the question is, which one should you go for? And the answer is, let's suppose you want to go from point A to point B. And if you want to go from point A to point B with maximum fuel economy, you should go for front-wheel drive vehicles because they are economical. And it's not that they cannot be fast. Chevrolet's Cruze is a front-wheel drive car and Skoda's Octavia RS is a 235 bhp, insanely fast sedan, is a front-wheel drive car. About rear-wheel drive cars, you can feel the difference in that push when the car is more powerful than 150 bhp. But in normal cars which are under 150 bhp, you don't find that difference very substantially. But at the same time, I must accept that rear-wheel drive cars are more fun to drive. All-wheel drive cars, if you are serious about actual off-roading, then only you should go for all-wheel drive cars. And for city drive also, all-wheel drive cars are good because they offer better traction and better stability and good control. On contrary, they are thirsty to drink a lot of fuel. But if you are looking for regular city drive with mild off-roading, don't fall for all-wheel drive or rear-wheel drive trap. Your front-wheel drive car is very much capable of doing it with better fuel economy. Was I able to clarify the difference? Well, don't thank me, thank Boardmo for supporting this video. Boardmo is revolutionizing auto spares industry in India. It's like Amazon and Flipkart, where you can go buy genuine spare parts and get them delivered at your home. You can download their application, check out their link below. And are you confused on your next new car purchase? WhatsApp us on this number. We will understand your needs and based on your needs, we'll suggest you right car because everyone has different needs. So what's the harm in asking? Thank you so much for watching this video. Do like, comment, share and subscribe. It keeps us motivated and your car healthy.